Welcome to part two. As I say, welcome to part two of Prime Sickness, episode 13 of Transformers Prime. Where we were left up to is that Bumblebee and went into Megatron's mind. So, Megatron's having this endless battle and glorious victory of defeating Prime and these Autobots. All these Autobot nemesises. But Bumblebee gets scared and hides behind like a rock fitting or crumbling piece of building. I think the place that he imagines is, at the same time, he's viewing what he sees back to the Autobots so the Autobots can see what is happening. After one battle with a certain battle with Megatron, he actually gets scared because it's so horrific how he does. He gets his sword blade, what's in his arm, punches Prime right through the neck and rips his head off. And he just turns to dust, this Prime, version of Prime. And he knocks over some rocks. Megatron spots this, turns around, starts firing his energy cannon. So, Megatron comes at him. And he's thinking, I didn't envision you yet. Why are you here? So he starts slicing at Bumblebee. But every hit that he gets is going right through him. Excuse me. He says, you're not part of my imagination. You're a hologram. He's saying, I'm not dead. Because he thought he was dead. He's in a long stasis lock. So, he imagines Bumblebee, RC, Bulkhead and Prime again and starts going crazy with his energy blaster cannon, fusion cannon again. So he says, you're not like the others, you're different. He's thinking, why are you here? And he's saying, you're this Prime Scout. He actually quotes that he is Prime Scouts and you're a hologram. He's saying, why are you here? Show me what's happened to me. Quite aggressively telling me now. But Bumblebee says he's here, basically says that he's here because Prime's sick and he's dying because of this plague that he, Megatron created. So Megatron says, makes a deal with Bumblebee. If he shows him what happens, he will show him the virus, the cure for the virus. And he shows him the actual last scene of Transformers Prime Episode 5, where Megatron's getting blows up by the space bridge. A cup of tea. Perfect. So, he says, right, I will only give you the cure. Owes a holographic cure for the virus, but Ratchet takes a picture of it so and scans it properly into the, because he's actually got seeing what's happening. So he says, I will only give you the cure if you get me out of this stasis and stop that fool Starscream destroying my army. But at the same time, then, John, while that's happening, Starscream, Knockout and Soundwave comes in and starts telling a load of pack of lies to Soundwave team. There's the inevitable. Megatron is dead, basically. He's in a coma. He's not going to come out. He points to saying his vital signs. He says, basically, he's brain dead. He's still functioning, but he's not going to know anything. He will never come out of it. Then, suddenly, Soundwave looks at Starscream and Knockout. Then, as he turns and looks at him, he notices the cable. He points it at it and says, Starscream says, what? What's the matter? Then Starscream sees the cable and says someone's in this room. So Bumblebee ejects himself out after finding the information that he needs. Megatron knows that he's been tricked and he actually says, take me now. Take me with you. So he gets sucked out. So RC jumps out with Bumblebee. Bumblebee's disorientated and she says, how about just allow me, cons. Let me do the dirty work for you. So she shoots at Megatron. And they jump out the space bridge. Jump into the space bridge down to the Autobot space. They cure Prime. Soundwave and Knockout are saying, oh well, he's dead. The Soundwave shakes his head and points at the finger. Cable says, then Starscream says, well, it doesn't seem fair if our glorious leader, in a sarcastic way, will fall by the hands of a Autobot scout. Oh, there's one more thing. While Bumblebee's in this, in Megatron's dream, Megatron asks him, saying, why should I help you? He turns around and says, basically, do you really want to spend the rest of eternity in a dream killing Primes and getting not the satisfaction that you want? Of not killing the real Prime. If you help us, we'll do anything you want so you can have the glory of facing your true enemy, the true Prime, the one and only Optimus Prime, by your own hands. He agrees. So, he kind of manipulates Megatron a lot to give him the cure. But then, no, that was just a bit that I missed out. Soundwave, no, it says basically, just hook him back up. So, Starscream connects life support back up, and Knockout turns around and says, "Excuse me, gentlemen, we have a problem." Saying Megatron's alive, but his brain's gone, his activity's gone, but his body's completely functional with a spark, with everything, but there's nobody on. And we're thinking, okay, what happens there? So, after Optimus Prime gets all better, he thanks the Scat, thanks Bumblebee. Say he's a true hero. So, this episode's all about Bumblebee and Megatron mostly. Like, last episode was all about RC. This one's about Bumblebee. So, Bumblebee just shakes his body, stands to still, and we go straight into his eyes, and it turns out Megatron escapes his memories into Bumblebee, and it's left open for another episode. So the next episode, even though it's going to go under by a different name, it's going to be a continuity from this episode. So I am really looking forward to this episode. I've seen the trailer for episode 14. It looks really good. I'm starting to get a bit more background and developments on the characters. We've had all the humans characters basically stories. Now we're getting on to the Cybertronians. I think we're going to see Optimus Prime's and Megatron's story next time, or even a bit more Bulkheads, or a bit more Bumblebees, I mean. But I would like to see Bulkhead, and like in episode 10, Duel of the Machines, seeing that Breakdown and Bulkhead says that they know each other, so they might show a bit of history between them two. But it's kind of, it's actually a very good episode. I say really, it's so good of an episode. I had to put this episode, this review into two videos. Oh, one more note, I have to admit, I've been waiting for this. It came out yesterday. Tekken, the movie. I've seen it on a mate's preview, pirate copy. It weren't as good, but it was an excellent movie. I've got it on Blu-ray, and I can't wait to see it. The story is actually brilliant. It's great, great cast, great stars. I am going to watch it later tonight. So I will suggest this will, I will be doing a review by the end of this year, my top geekiest moments, and this is going to be in it. So this is rattrap25 with another Transformers Prime review. Have a good night.